Good morning, everyone. So far, we have completed four chapters of your NCERT book. Before vacations, we have completed four chapters. So now we are going to start chapter 5, Lines and Angles. So let us recall what is the meaning of line and how angles are formed. Let us see the introduction part. In your previous class, you have learned about point, what is line segment, and ray. So let us discuss in brief what is a line. A line is always straight. You might have seen few lines are curved, but those are called curved lines. Here we are talking about line. So line is always straight. It has no thickness and it has no end point. It can be extended indefinitely in both directions. Let us see this figure. Here AB is a line. These arrows means we can extend this line to any length from both the directions. It is denoted by line AB. So this is the symbol, arrows on both sides. So this is the symbol for line AB. Now next is line segment. Line segment is a part of line. When a line has two endpoints, it is called a line segment. And it cannot be extended in both directions. It has a definite length. Line has indefinite length and line segment has a definite length. We cannot extend line segment in both the directions. See, this PQ. PQ is a line segment. These dots means it has a definite length. You might have drawn a line segment of length 5 cm, 4 cm. So these 5 cm, 4 cm are definite lengths. So line segment has a definite length and it is denoted by line PQ. So this is the symbol for line PQ. Next is ray. When a line has one endpoint, it is called a ray. It can be extended in one direction only. As you can see, the rays of sun. Sun is the starting point and its rays are going indefinite in all directions, so it can be extended in one direction. Similarly, it can be extended in one direction only. So this is OP, ray OP. This is called ray OP. It has a starting point and it can be extended to one direction indefinitely, and it is denoted by ray OP. So this is the symbol we can use for ray OP. You can take another example for rays, the light coming out from torch. So that is also an example of ray. Next is intersecting and non-intersecting lines. When two lines intersect at a point, they are called intersecting lines. So here AB is a line and CD is also a line. Both these lines are intersecting at point O, so that is why these lines are called intersecting line, and O is called the point of intersection. So here AB and CD are two intersecting lines and the point of intersection is O. Now what are non-intersecting lines? When two lines do not intersect anywhere in a plane, they are called non-intersecting lines or parallel lines. See here. Here AB is a line and CD is a line. If we extend these lines to any direction, they will not meet anywhere. They will not intersect anywhere. So that is why AB and CD are called non-intersecting lines, or the lines which never meet each other anywhere in a plane. They are also called parallel lines. And we know that the distance between parallel lines is always uniform, same. So these are about intersecting and non-intersecting lines. Next topic is, as the name of chapter is lines and angles, we have discussed about lines. Now we will discuss about angles. When two rays or lines or line segments intersect at a point or originate from the same point, an angle is formed. For example, see, this is the starting point. So OA is a ray and OB is another ray. So both the rays are originating from the same point. So when they originate from the same point, here an angle is formed. So this angle is called AOB. So this is angle AOB. So this is the symbol we can use for angle AOB. So in this figure, OA and OB are two rays. So you can see here, OA is a ray and OB is also a ray. So these two rays are called the arms of angles, and this is the starting point, and this is called, the starting point is called the vertex. So O is the vertex and OA and OB are the two arms of the angle. So in this figure, OA and OB are two rays starting from the same point O. An angle AOB is formed. O is the vertex and OA and OB are two arms of the angles. So I hope this is clear to all of you. Next is, now we can take another example. Similarly, we have this diagram ABC. Here you can see line segment AB and line segment BC intersects at B to form an angle ABC. So this an angle is formed when AB and BC, they intersect at B, angle ABC is formed. And when this line segment AC and BC intersect at point C, angle ACB is formed. And when AB and AC, they will intersect at point A, angle BAC or angle CAB is formed. So we will get three angles from this diagram. So these angles are ABC, ACB and BAC or CAB. So these are the three angles we get from this diagram. So I hope this is clear how we can recognize angles. Next is complementary angles. This is a part of angles. What are complementary angles? When the sum of the measure of two angles is 90 degrees, the angles are called complementary angles. You can see this example. This angle is of 30 degrees and this angle is of 60 degrees. So are these two angles complementary? Now we can see, if we add these two angles, answer is yes. When we add these two angles, the sum is 30 plus 60 is 90 degrees. And what are complementary angles? When the sum of the measure of two angles is 90, they are called complementary angles. We can take one more example. Suppose this is the, these are two angles. This is 50 degrees and this is 40 degrees. Now you can see 50 plus 40 is 90. Are these angles complementary? Yes. As the sum of these two angles is 90, so these are complementary angles. So when the sum of the measure of two angles is 90 degrees, they are called complementary angles. Whenever two angles are complementary, each angle is said to be the complement of other angle. What does it mean? You can see here, 30 degree angle is the complement of 60 degree angle, or we can say 60 degree angle is the complement of 30 degree angle. Next is supplementary angles. What are supplementary angles? Let us take an example. Here, this is the diagram of an angle. This angle is of measure 60 degree and this angle is of measure 120 degree. Here the sum of the measure of angles in the pair comes out to be, if we add these two angles, what does the sum comes out to be? 60 plus 120 is 180 degree. So when the sum of the two angles, the sum of measure of two angles is 180 degree, such pair of angles are called supplementary angles. And the same way, 60 degree is the supplement of 120 degree and 120 degree is the supplement of 60 degree. So I hope complementary and supplementary angles are clear to all of you. Next is adjacent angles. Now look at this diagram. In this figure, you can see we have angle AOC and BOC and angle AOB. Let us take these two angles, AOC and BOC. Observe these two angles carefully. We can see that in angle AOC and angle BOC, they have the common vertex O. They have common vertex O and they have common arm AOC and BOC. They have common arm OC and the non-common arms OA and OB are on the either side of this common arm. Either side means one on the left or other on the right, or one above or other below. So what you observed is, in these two angles, they have common vertex They have common arm, and the non-common arms are on the either side of this common arm. So these two angles are called adjacent angles. Such type of angles are called adjacent angles. You can see in the above figure, if we take two angles AOC and BOC, we observe that they have a common vertex O. You can see they have a common vertex O, common arm OC, and the non-common arms are on the either side of these two, of this common arm. So they are called adjacent angles. So such pair of angles are called adjacent angles. Now can you tell me angle AOC and AOB? AOC and AOB are adjacent. Now you can see AOC and AOB, we have a common vertex O. You can see from here also, they have a common vertex O, but they have a common arm AO. So common arm is AO, and the non-common arms are OC and OB. But you can observe that the non-common arms are not on the either side of common arm. They are on the, both the non-common arms are on the same side of common arm. So that is why these two angles are not adjacent. Next is linear pair. Next topic is linear pair. What is a linear pair? A linear pair is a pair of adjacent angles whose non-common sides are opposite rays. See here, in this example, angle 1, angle 2, are they form a linear pair? Yes, as the opposite rays. You can see in these two angles, OC is the common arm and O is the common vertex, and these are the non-common arms, OA and OB. So these angles form a linear pair because these opposite rays, OA and OB, are the non-common arms, and these opposite rays forms a straight line. When these non-common arms form a straight line, we always get a linear pair. So, and straight line means 180 degree angle. So angle 1 plus angle 2 is 180 degree. Angles in a linear pair are always supplementary. As we know, supplementary angles mean the sum should be 180. So that is why the sum of these two angles will also be 180. So linear pair means when the non-common arms form a straight line. They always form a linear pair. So angle 1 plus angle 2 is 180 degree. Next topic is vertical opposite angles. When two lines intersect at a point, two pair of vertical opposite angles are formed. Now see, as I have already explained you, these are two intersecting lines. AB and CD are two intersecting lines. When two lines intersect at a common point, we get four angles, angle 1, 2, 3 and 4. And opposite means in front of each other. So here you can see 1 and 3 are vertical opposite and 2 and 4 are vertical opposite. So here AB and CD lines intersect at a point forming angle 1, 2, 3 and 4. 1 is vertical opposite to 3. See, 1 is vertical opposite to 3 and 2 is vertical opposite to 4. So when two lines intersect, the vertical opposite angles so formed are always equal. So they are always equal. It means angle 1 is equal to angle 3 and angle 2 is equal to angle 4. So this completes your introduction part. Thank you.